at Pride Inn Hotels, Resorts and Camps, I was touched by the story that was given of the humble beginnings. And it gives it a lesson. Actually, niliposikia kwa makini, nikaelewa ya kwamba mara mingi watu wanaona biashara ikikuwa nzuri ama ikiendelea, wanafikiria imeanza tu hivyo. Na hiyo story ambayo tulipewa is a very clear indication that you can grow from small to big. Hello. And therefore, the hustler movement, those people who have just started, the boda-boda, the mamamboga, the tour operators, the tour guides, the small hotels, they can grow, they can become big, they can become strong, they can become powerful, they can become a brand. That is the lesson that I have learned. And therefore, I want to call upon every person, every Kenyan, every person listening. It is possible to start a business from the small to the big. Finally, I want to take this opportunity to congratulate the management. I was doing my statistics and I realized that they are employing over 1,500 permanent employees and there are also very many casuals. That is an indication that the tourism sector is employing a substantial number of people in Kenya and even worldwide. Therefore, I want to confirm the commitment of the Ministry of Tourism and Wildlife and the State Department of Tourism in particular that we are focused and very strategic in the transformation of tourism. I will not be able to mention all the things that I have written that I have wanted to mention because of time. But I just want to mention about three or four. Number one, tourism is not like any other. The people we depend upon to transform tourism are the private sector. And therefore, PrideInn, we are proud of you. All the other hotels, we are proud of you. All the airlines, we are proud of you. All the tour operators, travel agents, tour guides, everybody, we are proud of you. But the government is going also to support you in the following ways. Number one, you mentioned about the wedding tourism. We are already in discussion with the relevant government agent offices, the Attorney General, the Kenya Revenue Authority, the Department of Immigration, to see how we can grow wedding tourism in Kenya. Secondly, all other issues starting on e-visa, issues starting on infrastructure in our parks and so on, are things that we are looking at to ensure that we improve and grow the numbers of tourists. Finally, I told you I decided to leave my speech and whatever I wanted to say. Finally, we have started a journey together with the Cabinet Secretary and the entire Ministry of Tourism. First of all, to be able to map out all the touristic attractions in the country. And I'm very happy the CC members are here. We have already linked up with the county governments through the Council of Governors to be able to look at the 47 counties in Kenya and identify the unique attractions that they have. So that once we identify, one, we develop them. If they require infrastructure, if they require electricity, if they require water, so that they can be accessed, then we'll do that. And secondly, we market. You have heard the Kenya Tourism Board is now rebranded to be able to market the country in terms of tourism. And so because we are about to go and enjoy ourselves with a delicious dinner, I think I'll just decide to stop there, right? If you allow. Otherwise, I wish to give you more of what we are doing to transform tourism. And I know there will be another opportunity for me to do that. But for today, nataka kusema, Wow! Everybody say, wow! I'm not hard. Wow! What do you say for this new brand? What do you say? What do you say? What about for tourism in Kenya? What do you say? I'm not curious here. Tourism in Kenya, what do you say? Look, I want everyone to raise their hands like this. For tourism in Kenya, what do you say? Tourism in Kenya, what do you say? That's a very sad. Thank you very much.
Evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mohamed Osman. I'm the CEC Trade Tourism, Mombasa County. They call it County 001. Habari tena. I know I'm standing in between you and the gala dinner, so I'll be short in speech. But before that one, let me recognize my CEC, my colleagues here. This is Walai Karipuju.
Jambo, good evening to you all. What I can say is congratulations to PrideInn and our guarantee asante sana.
Shukran Diabo. Nafikiri kwa uchache sana ni kushukuru PrideInn as the Mombasa County Kwanza. Acha nitoe salamu zangu kutoka kwa governor wetu wa Kusoma Sharif Nasir. He had wished to be with you here, lakini mnajua kuna janga kidogo umetupata. We are struggling. Kuna rescue mission ambayo inafanyika kuwaokoa vijana wetu watatu ambao walikuwa wanajaribu kusaidia watu huko majengo. Kwa hivyo on behalf of Mombasa County, I wish PrideInn all the best in this. You have transformed these mice in Mombasa, and as a county, we are going to start with you. We are going to help you. I think as a stakeholders, we had our first meeting as stakeholders, and we agreed that we are going to form Mombasa Tourism Board. That is where all the stakeholders from County 001 will sit down on a quarterly basis and see how we can move this Mombasa and becomes a tourist hub. So those few words, I wish you all the best. I wish that Absama Sharif Nasir could be here with you, but unfortunately, due to unforeseen circumstances, he's not able. Convey his message. Thank you, and welcome to Mombasa. Everybody.
Earlier, there has been a lot of talk about Kenyan hotels not meeting standards. But look at what Hasnain and team have to offer. This is great investment. And as I said, Hasnain said, all the other hotels are all improving their services. I see Mebu and his team improving in Chennai. I see Janet there. Oh, there's also Janet, who's the chairperson of the Kenya Association of Women in Tourism. Janet. Just, even women are coming into it. So it's a big thing. I was not prepared to speak. Oh yeah, there's my CEO of KCTA. KCTA is an association of all the tourism players in the coast. And like you heard them say, coast is coming as one to sell this destination. It's not about competition. It's about one destination going out to sell. I would like to ask, take this opportunity to ask my PS. PS, there are a lot of things that are happening. Of course, you read them in the papers, you see them on social media. But PS, we need your support in the airports. Okay, nominating us, KCTA, we need your support in the airport to sort out this immigration issues. Hasnain said they're going for mice, and they're going to go for. There's a group that has booked for 2,000 people, a wedding, an Indian wedding, 2,000 packs, and they are flying in. coming in by charter. Now imagine if 2,000 people, now if you go to an Indian wedding, you can see the amount of gold that they put on, isn't it? You see, I mean, it's just gold walking. Now there's 2,000 of them coming in a short period of time at our airport. 2,000, oh, there's a lot of space. Okay, and I've got to watch out for other people who are looking for gold, stay away from them. But we want to ask PSP, when they come, let us ensure they're not being told, you know, you've got all this gold, start paying this, this dress is very expensive. You know, let's be courteous and welcome our people with love to the coast. With those very few remarks, thank you very much for coming. It was difficult to fit into my tax. I can't wait to get out of it. I've been holding my stomach for such a long time. But ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming and have a lovely evening. Congratulations.
So my name is Hasnain Noorani, the Group Managing Director of the PrideInn Hotels and Resorts. Today is one of those biggest milestones. It's a very big day for us at the PrideInn Hotels, because today is the day where we have finally rebranded. We have launched our new brand, and it's one of those biggest milestones that we have achieved today. We started our operations in 2011. And over time, we have grown from one hotel to 8 hotels in 5 different counties. We started with 28 rooms, and today we have over 900 rooms with conference capacities of 15,000 people. We started off as a budget brand, but over time, with the market dynamics, having learned what our clients wanted, we invested heavily in training. We invested heavily in modernizing our hotels to bring in the luxury status. And as we stand today, we are very proud that PrideInn has a new face. And we have invested, we have shredded off all the budget hotels. We acquired new luxury hotels, invested in all our hotels to give them the luxury feel, the luxury standards. After having invested all that money into the hotels, we decided that it was time to announce to our guests that this is what we have become. We have had our experience for 10 years. We have learned a lot of things, and we know exactly what our clientele require now, what our guests require. We know exactly what our international guests, what our local guests, our regional guests, and our guests who come in for MICE, for the meetings, incentives, conferences, and exhibitions. And after having a bit of a brainstorm, we decided it was time to do a rebrand, because when we opened PrideInn, we opened as a budget brand. We were very successful in marketing as a budget brand. 12 years down the line, market dynamics changed, and based on that, we positioned our hotels to become luxury hotels, and a rebrand was a must so that we could announce to our guests, we could tell our clients, our loyal clients, our old clients, and to our future clients that PrideInn is an epitome of luxury. And this is a brand that is fully focused on exceeding customer expectation. We want to deliver exceptional products and services in line with our vision, which is to become the leading hospitality brand in Africa. So in line with our rebrand, we are becoming a very people-focused brand. We want to forge human connections. We want to forge connections with our staffs. First prize, our first priority. And after that, we want to forge connections with our customers, with the community around us, with our partners, stakeholders, with our respective colleagues within the industry. And we want to ensure that we are able to deliver an exceptional product, we are able to deliver an exceptional service in line with what we have created, known as our focus for the next 2 years, is something that we call FIZ. FIZ simply stands for food experience, individualized and personalized service, zero waste and zero complaints. So this is what, as a PrideInn Group, as part of the rebrand, we are focusing on the FIZ experience to ensure we are able to give our guests, our esteemed guests, our esteemed clients, the luxury experience that PrideInn is now going to demonstrate. that PrideInn has been giving, and we are looking forward to showcasing and redefining hospitality. Yes, this year, as part of the rebrand, we recreated our SOPs, we recreated our policies, we recreated our brand manuals, and we have now set the foundation into place. And today, now that we have rebranded, our new logo and the new face and the new look of PrideInn has been unveiled. We are happy to announce that along with the new face and the new look, we have already earmarked 10 counties where we want to expand towards. We are very excited, very optimistic about the future of tourism in this beautiful country, Kenya. And we know that the government has a vision of 5.5 million tourists by 2027. To be able to achieve the 5.5 million tourists, we believe as PrideInn Hotels, Resorts and Camps, we can play a very important and a very pivotal role. Generally, the gateway for growing tourism is accommodation and the accommodation experiences. Having a good accommodation, having a good conference center is the gateway to open up any county. And we are looking at working hand in hand. And mind you, to be able to achieve the 5.5 million tourists, all right, by just working and selling the traditional circuits, we'll no longer hack it. We have to think outside the box, and we have to start focusing on the various tourism experiences. And therefore, as part of PrideInn, as the managing director of PrideInn, myself and my entire team, we are very focused in working hand in hand with the government to achieve the 5.5 million tourists. And how do we want to work? Is by opening up hotels and conference centers in the various counties, so that we can be able to pull in the international MICE, the regional MICE meetings, and along with also local MICE meetings. We want to create our hotels that focus on business and on leisure also. And with the leisure element, we want to be able to target and reintroduce several tourism circuits within the country. New experiences, magical experiences, and then be able to target the leisure clientele, both internationally, the domestic leisure clientele, and also the regional. And we are very bullish, we are optimistic, and we are very excited on what the future holds for PrideInn Hotels, Resorts and Camps, as we have now unveiled and we have rebranded.
Remember, we have the best party. Our maintenance team. Followed by the kitchen team.
Thank you very much. So we have the kitchen team, we have the maintenance team, and we have the spa. Thank you very much.
Majina yangu naitwa Jackton Amtala, mkurugenzi mkuu wa utendaji PrideInn Group of Hotels. Leo tulikuwa tunafanya uzinduzi wa nembo mpya ya hii hoteli yetu ya PrideInn, na kutoka Nairobi mpaka Mombasa zote sasa zina change rangi yake, kutoka kwa ile rangi nyekundu kwa ile rangi ya blue. Utendakazi wetu unabadilika, because zamani tulikuwa tunajulikana kama hoteli ile ya ndogo ndogo zile za kuanzisha, lakini sasa tumekuwa hoteli ya kubebea, ambapo tuko na hoteli za the star kama 5-4 kuendelea. So lazima wananchi wajue mahali tumefikia kwa sasa hivi, ili tuendelee na kazi mzuri, wananchi wote wajue bila tunakuja. Ndio wageni wetu wakikuja, hata wale wa kutoka Ulaya wahakikishe kujua kwamba tuko na hoteli za kifahari nchi Kenya. Unajua wakati corona ilikuja, ilifanya tukarudi nchini Kenya kutafuta wananchi wa Kenya. Lakini kama unavyofahamu, corona ilileta shida tukarudi Kenya, lakini sasa hivi dola imeenda juu, lazima tutafute wageni wa nchi za kigeni wakuje. Na hiyo tu ndio itawezesha pia Kenya kuwa nambari moja kwa katika foreign currency ana. PrideInn Hotels ilikuwa moja ya hoteli zile tu za katikati, lakini kwa sasa sisi ni mojawapo ya hoteli za kujulikana na za kifahari nchini Kenya. Na haswa sana tukiwa ni hoteli ya wenyeji wakiwa ni wenyeji wananchi wa Kenya imetufanya tuko na roho nzuri kwa sababu build Kenya by Kenya. Tuko na hoteli kwa katika county 5 nchini Kenya. Tuko Masai Mara, tuko na Machakos, tuko Nairobi, tuko Mombasa na tuko na Kwale.
We started in 2011 with our first hotel in Western with 38 rooms only. In a short period of time, we grew from one hotel in Nairobi County to 8 hotels in 5 different counties.